Now, look at the picture and see how the numbers are big. 1.5 billion people don't have access to electricity worldwide. This is almost 20% of all humanity. Now, the key source of energy is fossil fuels. Therefore, the developing countries which don't have the natural resources, they are struggling with this problem. And humanity is working on the problem and proposing a new solution, which is renewable energy. However, it has a high price and therefore it needs some subsidies. Now, let's compare the cost of the renewable energies with fossil fuels. In Kazakhstan, fossil fuels electricity cost is 7 cents per kilowatt hour. And you can compare it how it's high. Solar panel is almost 5 times higher. And another option is energy power, wind power. So we have two types of different wind power. It's vertical axis wind turbine and horizontal axis wind turbine. And the cost of vertical axis wind turbine is twice higher than the cost of horizontal ones. This is due to the efficiency, low efficiency, which is twice lower. So according to this table, we can conclude that the solution for this would be horizontal axis wind turbine, because it's the cheapest one. But another problem is technology accessibility in the developing countries. So, because horizontal axis wind turbines is so hard, it has this so complex technology of maintenance, installation, and transportation. Only 10% of all developing countries had adapted that. Among the developing countries, it's only India and China. And if you see at the vertical axis wind turbine, it's really, really paradox. Despite it has a higher cost, developing countries had adapted it more than that and covers 35% of the vertical axis wind turbine. It means that the adaptability of technology, accessibility of technology plays a big role in developing countries. If you could get down lower the cost of vertical axis wind turbines, that would be our solution. And that's what we did. Genghis Khan wind turbine has 10 cents of cost of 10 cents per kilowatt hour and is very, very easy to install, maintain, and very easy technology to transfer. Now, what makes it so cost efficient? First of all, you have, if you look at the prototype here, it has a pectop design which makes it work on gyroscope principle, which means the higher you turn, the better it stays on the ground, just like a pectop type point. So that gives a high wind work range. Also, it doesn't need any guy wires to hold the machine because it's stable. This makes it twice cost efficient. Now, we have a business model which gives us two key revenue sources. First is that to manufacture the turbines with a local metal workshops. This is because we know the market. And the second one is to make a profit share agreement with the overseas leaders in manufacturing. So now we have signed a memorandum of understanding with Alka Group, which is a leading manufacturing company in Turkey. We have patented the technology, we have made a prototype, a completed laboratory test. Now we're going to invest more $80,000 to complete the technology.
Thank you, Ardak. We're going to have to cover the rest during the Q&A. With that, I'll turn it over to the panel. Janet.
Can you talk a little bit more about completing the technology?
I'm sorry,
about completing the technology. What do you mean? I mean, are you ready to go into production? Can you talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, basically to finish my presentation, right? now the only thing which is left is to do our field test. We have completed laboratory analysis based on the little prototype. Now we're going to build a bigger one with 2 kilowatt hours, kilowatt capacity, and we set it on the field and take a data for 3-4 months. And for this, we need $80,000, which we have won already grant from the government, and just need to pass through all this bureaucratic process.